have a challenge in terms of making sure that they're making the right decisions.
All right.
So far, I think the systems are there for dispute resolution. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dismas, I'd like to hear your thoughts on that one. Will the parties be able to deal with the issues arising after this primaries?
Well, I think, again, expecting the parties to sort out the issues, again, is a waste of time.
Really?
Yeah, because these political parties...
This must you don't have any good thing to say.
No, you know, it's important to call a spade a spade. Because look, for instance, look at ODM or Wiper or Ford Kenya or Amani National Congress. These are not political parties. These are special purpose vehicles owned by the various leaders. Because, you know, they're not anchored on any ideology. Like, for instance, if you are in the West, then you wouldn't say that the Democratic Party belongs to Obama. When Obama was born, there was a party called Democracy.
Yes.
Joined it, rose through the ranks, became a presidential candidate, is taking a walk.
Leave.
But in Kenya now, you have ODM. ODM, in the absence of Raila Odinga, you don't have ODM. So if there is a dispute, say, in Busia, it's going to depend on the thinking of Raila Odinga. If Raila Odinga wants Ojamong or he wants Otuoma, that board led by Judy Pereno would be looking at Raila's body language and trying to interpret what does he want. Now, if Raila wants, say, Otuoma, and Ojamong has got a very valid case, Ojamong is not going to get justice anywhere. So you go sit with that internal resolution body, you'll be wasting your time. So you're better off jumping to an independent organization.
And that's for all parties or specific parties?
I think for most parties, especially for ODM and Wiper. I've not seen evidence of mischief in Amani National Congress and Ford Kenya, and of course Jubilee.
Why is that?
I mean, you know, at this stage, when you're putting together your team, people are looking at 2022 and they're looking at even other elections. So you want guys who are loyal to you 100% today to win the general election on August 8th so that you start executing your 2022 agenda. Right now, like for instance, the reason I told you that I'm surprised about Jubilee is I would have expected the deputy president to be sure that his fingerprints are all over so that the guys who are loyal to him 100% are the ones who retain the National Assembly position, mm-hmm. Senate, and a gubernatorial position, so that he puts together a system for 2022. But again, you cannot rule that one out, because there were reports appearing in some newspapers that there's already a list of preferred candidates,
yeah.
And people are being given resources for this kind of financing. Like, for instance, would you imagine that this gentleman running against Mandago called Buzeki, he just crawled from nowhere and is having a very serious campaign which has been well oiled?
Maybe
and
he has been planning for some time.
He's been planning for some time. But again, I can tell you, having spent a lot of time with these politicians, you will not crawl from the woodwork and say that I want to run for a particular position, mm-hmm. without getting the blessings of the party leader. Look at Elizabeth Ongoro. For the longest time, she's been an insider of ODM. This is the kind of lady who would strip naked at Uhuru Park because of Raila Odinga. But because TJ Kajwang is the preferred candidate for ODM in that constituency in Ruaraka, Ongoro was told, you have to pack your bags and take a walk. So now she decided to jump to Amani National Congress.
She was told to choose another position.
But you see...
Be a bit softer.
Yeah. Calling a spade a spade. If I want to run in Ruaraka and I've invested resources, because again, running for a parliamentary seat is not a walk in the park. You have to know the voters, you have to know the polling stations, you have to put a number of people almost on your payroll. Mm. You have to know their birthdays, pay for their funerals and everything. And Ongoro has been doing that for the last 4 years. So she understands Ruaraka like the back of her hand.
Okay.
And then somewhere, a guy at the head office says, "Wait a minute, we want Kajwang, so you go look for another constituency." So where in Kenya would Elizabeth Ongoro go and start putting up her campaign infrastructure
in a week's time.
So that you start running for this election? That one doesn't happen. So there is mischief there. And part of the reason, again, when you talk about Amani, the reason why Amani is not being covered as much is because I think their party primaries are maybe... You know, consistent with the name that they're peaceful. There's a lot of peace in the way they're being done.
No, we'll get to Amani shortly and we'll talk about their candidates. But even so, I had their senior leaders here and they said that they will not be participating in very many, of this contests. And therefore, maybe it's a matter of waiting for those ones that they're going to be strong in and have a conversation about that.
Yeah, but again, going back to those political parties, then it tells you we don't have parties anchored on philosophies or ideologies. We have community parties in Kenya. Mm. For instance, ODM would be very strong in the Luo-speaking areas,
right.
And maybe Luhya.